This draft is really good when it comes to defense. Here's my top defensive players available for this year's NFL draft. Let's start with number 5, Devin White, the linebacker from LSU. Speed, speed, and more speed. He goes sideline to sideline in the run game, but here's where it really helps him, in pass defense. His coverage ability is terrific. He's a guy that can stay on the field on third down. He can stay with running backs, maybe even slot receivers, and he's big enough to even stay with tight ends. It's that hybrid nature that I think makes him one of the top 5 defenders in this draft. At number 4, it's the defensive end slash defensive tackle from Michigan, Rashawn Gary. There's a reason he was Bruce Feldman's number 1 freak going into last year. He is explosive and powerful. This guy wins on the edge, sets as hard an edge as I've seen in a long time, but he can also win in the interior. Rashawn Gary is a guy that I think can be impactful on almost every single snap. I think his lack of production at Michigan was more a result of what the schematics were around him. They played a different style of defense where he wasn't asked to do what Nick Bosa did at Ohio State, which was just get to the quarterback at all times. Because of his movement, his production was a little bit down from where other great edge players were, but make no mistake about it. This dude is a freak, and he's one of the top defensive players available. At number 3, it's Josh Allen, the edge player from Kentucky. This guy is long and athletic, and he's very fast. He is understated, a humble guy, but make no mistake about it. He can get to and affect the passer at the next level. His ability to use the speed rush and then the counter moves off of that, I think, is his best asset. He is athletic enough to get out in space and cover if need be. But Josh Allen, if you get him on your team, you're getting an excellent defender that is going to be in the backfield affecting the passer at the next level. At number 2, it's Quinnen Williams, the defensive tackle for Alabama. This dude is sensational. I think if he were an edge player, he would be considered the top defender, but because he's interior and Nick Bosa is exterior, that's why they're going to be slotted at 1 and 2. We'll get to Bosa in just a second. Williams is phenomenal. His ability to take on a double team and yet still be productive is uncanny. He's got a great motor for a player with his skill set. He's big, he's strong, he's tough, he's got a great mentality, and he can move up and down the defensive line. This dude is a steal, even at the top of the draft. I think he is a premier defensive player early in his career in the NFL. And my top defensive player available, like I just mentioned, it's Nick Bosa. This dude is unreal. He's got the bloodlines, obviously, with his brother, Joey. But when you actually watch his tape, what you see is when he's on the field, he is being impactful every single snap. Run game, passing game, with his power, with his quickness, his ability to run the edge, his ability to bull rush with his strong hands. He's the best defender in the draft. I do not see a scenario in which Nick Bosa is not an all-pro outside of injury in his first 3 seasons in the NFL. He is a surefire pick in this draft. There's no mistake about it. I think he's going to be the number 2 pick to San Francisco.